Here at UCSF, we're introducing virtual reality for the first year medical students that corresponds with their first learning block. So when they leave the cadaveric lab, they can immediately come over to the virtual reality lab and they can learn the same material they just saw on the cadaver in a virtual space. In virtual reality, they can go from the skin level all the way down to the bones and take every single layer off as they go, see the relationships, how they're stacked up, how they're aligned. And then when they get to the bones, they can repeat it almost like a puzzle and put all the pieces right back on there, all the way back out to the skin.
Today, I spent 3 hours in the anatomy lab, and then I went straight from that to working on the virtual reality anatomy lab, essentially, where I was able to sort of pull the muscles apart that I had been looking at on the cadavers. I think the cadaver experience is really, you know, integral to our medical education, and you know, Derek and the whole staff does an amazing job of instructing us and taking us through the cadavers and being able to see those muscles on those bodies. But at the same time, you know, it's a little bit difficult to get an entire three-dimensional picture of what's going on. With the VR, it's sort of like a process, you know, where you can build it and rebuild it, and I think that sort of helps understand the anatomy a lot better and a much more in-depth experience.
One of the hardest things for students in anatomy, at least early on, is understanding that spatial relationship of everything in the body. Virtual reality is exciting for me as an anatomy instructor because it's going to be able to enhance the students' understanding of the arrangement of the body. Because the better they know the body, the better physicians they'll end up being the rest of their career.